Tomorrow, Uganda will join the rest of the world to celebrate International Women's Day in events slated to take place in Kiruhura District under the theme Equal Opportunities in Education, Science and Technology for Innovation and a Gender Equal Future. According to Uganda Women Parliamentary Association, UWOPA, even though the country has made strides in gender equality, they still need to reflect on the unfinished strategies to achieve this.
Girls and women still face barriers when it comes to accessing technology, and by the time such themes make it on the global platform, you realize that there's still need to advance technology for bettering the women's agenda. Currently, when you look at the ratios in education and everywhere, you realize that women who take up science subjects are few. And even when you come to the employment sector, we still have few women taking up high scientific jobs. So we as WOPA, we pledge to do more work to make sure that we have a budget that is engendered, a budget that will promote women in science, and also to have women access internet nationally.
Female MPs claim that the country cannot continue to talk about digital era when interest connectivity has not remained a big concern, while the cost of internet data keeps skyrocketing to the extent that it disables women from using technology.
In Uganda, data expires, and when you've actually paid for it, this does not happen in other countries. So we find that there are so many negatives while we push for access everywhere and an inclusive society when it comes to technology. We feel there are barriers, and we are going to move a motion soon in regards to high tariffs so that we can cure this problem as we advance the women's gender in regards to the digital space.
The women have called for the need to tackle teenage pregnancies, which according to them is stopping several girls from completing school and becoming future scientists.
There are a number of girls who usually intend to pursue sciences, but if they get pregnant before the time that they aimed at getting pregnant, just know they will not complete education.
Female MPs also urge the government to step up implementation of gender-related laws and policies which were enacted to protect women and girls from violence in society.
The sports women or girls who have not yet been identified and they're out there lying, they don't know where to tap, they don't know who to work with, but we are committed as WOPA to identify that talent, that girl who is lying there, who has never moved but is sleeping with a talent that needs to be explored, that needs to fly high, the flag of this nation. So the women agenda will have to be driven together with me and you and every other person in this nation so that the girl child is treated equally like the boy child.
The executive director of Joy for Children, Moses Ntega, who joined female MPs in the joint presser, called on the government to review gaps in the education system, which are stopping young girls from taking up science and ICT jobs.
Uganda has made some very tremendous progress that the government has been able to support. We acknowledge that there is a lot of learning that is happening through technology. There is access to mobile phones as well as financial services, even some of the rural communities. We also know there's access to sexual reproductive health and information, and also there's access to connectivity and social networks for women and girls as opposed to when women were locked up in the houses, but now they're able to communicate. But also we know that gaps still exist, and that's why I think we're here, that we appreciate the positives that have been done, but also look into some of the challenges that we have. Thank you very much.